straight fresh, killing the beat. So look, we could move on from that. I think we covered as much as we could. Next up, this is my last story. Because we're gonna do the DJ Envy Tyrese one. We're gonna let you cover that one. So look, academics pressured AD to talk about the situation where Adam was going super hard, dissing Figmunity and Community and back on Fig, and he was wondering why AD never responded to those, you know, to Adam, and he was trying to pressure him. But I like the way that AD conducted himself, bro, because even though academics was trying to get a reaction out of AD, AD kept his cool, was like, man, you know, he's like, it's content, man. And AD ain't out here trying to crash out. I feel him. He about to be a millionaire if he ain't already, you know. Right. So I respect him for that. But yeah, let me play the clip where academics is, you know, trying to make, you know, convince ask AD why he didn't crash out against Adam, pretty much.
Why the fuck did y'all not respond? Because I'm gonna be honest with you, I felt Adam kind of punked y'all. I'm gonna be honest.
That's cool.
I felt, I'm like, yo, damn, Adam, yo, my man say he big 22. I'm gonna be honest, because I'm not no fake nigga. I even, shit. Like, I think he said, yo, somebody, Van Lathan, something told him, like, yo, you kind of like biting act type shit. And I told him, I said, I don't think you biting me. I think, you, like, big whatever. Whether it's big AD, big act, big 22 as he was going by, it's a persona, or it's a part of your persona that's just not going to like allow shit to fly. And he was going crazy at y'all. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Not you as much, but he definitely took some issue with Smack. And I ain't gonna lie, look, like, I don't know what's going on with him and T-Rep, but he was trying to fire him up.
So I just want to comment on something real quick, man. Like, so don't it seem, I mean, he, academics had this long
academics instigating
question. Yeah, exactly. Academics had this long-winded question of pretty much asking him why you ain't crash out against Adam, AD, why you ain't crash out. And I'm like I said, we're gonna continue playing it, but I just had to pause it and say that, like, why are you trying to just get to the point, bro? You know that's what you really wanted to ask the nigga, bro. Why you didn't crash out against Adam? Mm-hmm.
And I watched the whole thing, and I'm like, Adam might have took the dub. I said he was up 3-1. And I think it might have been a closeout because I ain't see the response I thought it was going to happen.
Wanted that, so let me tell you, let me ask you something. What did you expect for us to do in that situation?
I expected y'all to defend yourself because
how though? Online?
Crash out. No, like, no.
Go do some shit.
We're doing content. We're doing content. Okay. And that was the message I was hoping to be. Like, listen, we're doing content. You know, sometimes a lot of these words that get said, there could be some non-content shit that happens behind it. Mm-hmm. Trust me, Charlamagne told me that 10 years ago.
That's what we just said.
we literally just said that, bro. And that's the whole point of why, because AD, at the end of the day, we could go ahead and stop playing that. At the end of the day, AD knows that he might be a personality now, but once a street nigga, always a street nigga. You know what I'm saying? Right. And responding to this with knowing what Adam was saying and the interviews he was doing and the rants he was going on his podcast, responding to that can sometimes, making it only content ain't enough for a street nigga. So it's better to just ignore it altogether. And I feel like AD did a good job by not even ignoring the noise. But I will say that a part of me, for entertainment purposes, a part of me wished they did respond.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I could lie. Like, I respect it, but a part of me was like, damn, nigga, like, I want to see on an entertainment basis, I want to see y'all niggas flexing y'all cards and see who really, you know, who got the bigger hand here. Because the AD, I mean, Adam was saying some wild shit. Oh, they ain't making no as much money as me, da 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 da. All this crazy stuff, you know.
They ain't going to do nothing. They ain't going to slide. Yeah. He was all that crazy.
All that. So what's your thoughts, man?
I mean, yeah, he definitely AD definitely played it cool. He definitely did the right thing. I know he slipped some stuff in here and there, like on his, you know, during his little podcast or whatever. well, I ain't gonna say little podcast, but I'm saying like during his, you know, his videos and stuff. But he would slip stuff in here and there, but he never really responded directly because it wasn't really, I think at that point, everything that needed to be said had been said. I think the only reason why Adam 22 even said what he said and responded the way he responded was because of the things that were being said by other people around AD. You know, of course, there's so many people that come on. You have community, and then you have back on Fig, and then you also have Figmunity, you know, where they do Shame on You. So it's like it's they all have their own cast and different guests. So everybody would have something to say, and they all had questions about what was going on when that whole split happened. So they were, I think they were harping on it a little bit for a little longer than people anticipated. And Adam decided to respond back. And at that point, like I said, all the main people who were involved, AD, T-Rail, all these people, they weren't really the ones who were antagonizing it. They were the ones that kind of just basically, you know, were like, hey, I'm gonna just, you know, we said what we have to say, it's over with. But like I said, it was their homies. So he definitely played it right. I don't think there's anything that needs to be said by them on that. Mm-hmm. If they do respond, it just kind of makes them look like they're taking it personal. Exactly. And then like how Academic said, it's a content game. So it's all about us trying to get the content. We understand that. But at the same time, I don't think AD is responding because he's not trying to give Adam 22 any content.
Agreed.
And facts. That makes sense.
And at this point in time, I think they both benefit equally off the content they could create off of talking about each other. So you can't make the argument that back on Fig, community and them have more of a benefit than they do when it comes to content than Adam does. If you look at the numbers of No Jumper, bro, pre AD split, pre T-Rail split, and everybody that left, No Jumper was doing a lot well numbers wise. Only thing that had made them have this major boost was when Lena ended up getting smashed out. You know what I'm saying? So technically, you know, No Jumper was a sinking ship. So I like how, you know, AD and everybody on that side is conducting themselves and not feeding into the controversy just for clicks. They like, nigga, because you remember Adam made that comment, oh, y'all can't survive without talking about us. And this moment where they had a perfect opportunity, he called them
No Jumper reactions channel,
which was super disrespectful. But I'm glad they're not feeding into that energy, man. So I WAD, you know what I'm saying, for holding his own, because he pretty much was avoiding that question by Academic.